Good afternoon, Lake Havasu City. I am Mayor Cal Sheehy, and we're here today to answer your questions. These are questions that you have called our offices with or sent emails, and we wanted to answer these questions for all of our citizens. But before we do, we just wanted to check in and see how everyone's doing. You know, these are very trying times, and I just ask that you remain calm, remain kind, and be patient. We are going to make it through this. And I appreciate all of our citizens that are going above and beyond to check on their neighbors, to check on their loved ones, and make a phone call to that special person. Again, we are going to get through this.
Thank you, Mayor Sheehy. That's some very good advice for our residents. And good day, Havasu. And we're here back with a video to answer some of the questions that are coming in, as you indicated, Mayor Sheehy. So let's go ahead and get started with our first question. The one we're hearing about the most right now is, why doesn't the city shut down the lake? And so I'd like to kind of pose that to you, to Mayor. Some of the concerns coming from the residents are in relation to it's driving tourists to the area. We have a senior population and more so than other cities in Arizona, and certainly higher than the national average in terms of age demographics with regards to our hospitals and healthcare. And we're very concerned about overwhelming our local healthcare facilities. And so some of the folks in the community are saying, we need to stop this right now. Let's shut down the lake and prevent anybody from coming to Havasu, as well as maybe the inability for social distancing and avoiding large groups. So Mayor Sheehy, is that something the city can do? Can we shut down the lake?
Yeah, you know, it's a great question that we continue to hear over and over again. And I thank everyone for sharing their thoughts and concerns with us. But unfortunately, we don't have the ability to close the lake. Lake Havasu is a federal waterway, and the mayor does not have the authority to close down or shut down the lake. The conversation quickly turns to then, what about shutting down or closing the boat launch ramps? And the major ramps here in Lake Havasu City or in this region are in state parks controlled by the state. And I have reached out not only to the governor's office, but also to the Arizona State Parks Department to talk about their strategy with the state park system. And with the governor's executive order, it leaves outdoor recreation open. And they're taking that guidance from the governor's office and intend to leave state parks open throughout the state, including like Havasu City. And so it doesn't make sense to close down one or two launch ramps when all of the other launch ramps will be open. Because if we do that, we would just be pushing more people into smaller spaces, and that would defy the social distancing that we're asking everybody to do. I'll say it again, and I've said it multiple times, now is not the time to travel. Now is the time to stay home. And for our citizens, it's also the time to stay home. We know the way to slow the spread of the virus is to social distance and limit exposure and contact. And so I just would remind citizens and visitors that we encourage you to stay home during these trying times.
Thank you, Mayor Sheehy. That's great information. So what is your message to people that are keep calling your office, contacting your office and saying, hey, I want to travel to Lake Havasu City? What is the message we're sending to those that want to come here for the weekend and ignore the situation we're in right now?
You know, another great question that we continue to get. And my message is to stay home. Many of our surrounding states also have stay-home orders, and I urge you to please follow your stay-home orders. Late last week, I released a statement, and I said to our visitors, we love everything about you. We love that you love Lake Havasu, and it's such a special place for you. It's a special place for us, too. But right now, the health and safety of our citizens is at risk, and we ask that you stay home until our citizens are not at risk anymore. So at this time, we are encouraging all of our visitors and urging you to stay home, and we'll welcome you back when this pandemic is behind us and we're safe and healthy again to do so. So please stay home during these times.
Thank you, Mayor Sheehy. We have been in communication with the county and the public health department for Mojave County over the last couple of weeks, and we've been asking them to provide some more information for the region. And they put together some resources that we can all take a look at. Mayor Sheehy, in addition to what the state provides, where can our residents go to learn more information about testing and cases and so forth?
Yeah, great question. We continue to get this question from citizens about testing and the results of testing and where I can get data. There's a variety of sources, but there's two trusted sources. So if you want to get the data for the entire state, I recommend that you go to the Arizona Department of Health Services website. And you'll be able to get county by county data for each region and see how the spread of the virus and the confirmed cases are in each county in Arizona. And then Mojave County Department of Public Health is the lead agency in our area. And on their website at mojavecounty.us, you'll find a big banner that says Coronavirus Hub. Click on that when you go to the homepage, and you'll be able to see data about testing and confirmed cases in Mojave County and our respective cities. So it's very valuable and very useful information. It's updated daily, so I encourage you to take a look at that. But all of the information is readily available for our citizens to be able to get and verify and check. So again, the two places would be the Arizona Department of Health Services and the Mojave County Department of Public Health.
Fantastic. That's great information for the public to understand and to know and to learn more about what's happening in our area with regards to COVID-19. So one final question for you, Mayor, is we had a lot of questions about what's the city doing? What's been the response been from the city? What are you doing, Mayor Sheehy, in response to this pandemic? And where can the citizens go to get more information or learn about these activities?
Yeah, thank you for that question. It's so hard as an elected official. I'm used to being out in public and at gatherings and in group events where I can talk to each one of you one-on-one. And it's hard that I can't do that right now. But I have been working very, very hard and tirelessly with my colleagues here at the city, our city council, public health experts throughout the state to ensure that we have the resources for our citizens. I've been working with our federal legislators, our senators and our congressmen about efforts at the federal level. I've been working with the state. Governor Ducey's office is hosting calls with mayors across the state so we can talk about how do we impact and slow the spread of this virus from a regional and a state perspective. We've also been working on different relief efforts and also planning and preparing for the healthcare needs of our community during this pandemic. You can go to our website, lhcaz.gov, and click on the COVID-19 button or tab, and you'll be able to learn all of the activities that we're doing. But we're working every single day, all day long and into the evening, to make sure that we slow the spread of the virus, we communicate with you, our citizens, about the importance of the stay-home order and all of the activities that are surrounding this pandemic, and we continue to make sure that we get this information out to you. I would encourage you to go to our website as well when you're visiting the website to see what we're up to and what we're doing, to subscribe to our newsletter. We want to be able to reach out to you directly, and we can do that by you going to our website and subscribing to our newsletter, the mayor's newsletter, and we'll send out weekly updates via email to each one of our citizens that signs up for this so that you have up-to-date information at that time. For many of you that I've been speaking with, you've heard me say this multiple times over the last several weeks that we've been in this pandemic, but every day is almost like a week in the amount of information that comes available and the amount of resources that change. And so that information will be brought to you weekly, and we'll be able to compile all of that so you have the most up-to-date information that we have. And I thank you for all of your support, and I thank you for following the governor's stay home order and only using essential services. And together, we're going to slow the spread, and we'll be able to have this pandemic behind us, and we'll be able to move forward as a city, as a state, and a country.